Sherman at Fallsbrook is one of those tank monuments that's been here since World War II and has a great deal of history. Just by looking at this Sherman for a few minutes tells you a little bit what happened on the day the tank was knocked out. That's why this particular tank monument is my favorite in the area. The tank is also an eye catcher, not just because of the battle scars, but just because she stands next to a highway off ramp on a rest area, so she will get a lot of visits from people that are on their day off, families with screaming children, and people that just need to take a piss. And when I was recording the failed live stream, a guy starting to take a piss right behind me, making my live stream filming somewhat difficult. He also was looking at me like I was crazy, because I was talking to myself with a camera in my hand. But I really find it funny and amusing that a lot of people in historical channels are always trying to romanticize places like this. I enjoy the history and some of the historical surroundings, but it's really funny in trying to romanticize a moron with a camera talking to himself with a guy behind him pissing against a tree. Still, I love the historical value of this tank, a tank that has a lot of penetrating shots, with one that just rammed through the whole tank, and this is also the damage that is the biggest eye catcher. It's fascinating to see and explore for yourself. But still, all these people driving by to work or to their summer destinations and the people stopping here are reminded of the sacrifice these soldiers made on this day in November. On 21st of November of 1944, this M4A3 Sherman advanced on the town of Fallsbrook when it took fire and the diver decided to take cover behind a small embankment. But the Sherman still got hit by a glancing blow on the roof of the driver's compartment. The force was so strong that it killed the driver. After this, the shell bounced off the turret. And at this point must have been real hectic in the Sherman. The gun was pointing to the southeast and the 88 was located in the northeast. But before they could turn the gun around, the tank was hit in the turret ring, jamming the turret. And with no driver, the tank was a sitting duck. The turret took several hits and one went through the turret ammo hatch, busting through the other side of the turret. The crew of the 88 clearly focused on shooting the turret of the tank. Probably because they had a limited view of the Sherman, but the last shot was on the hull and that shot set the tank on fire. The crew bailed out and were supported by an M3 half-track. The crew got in safely, but then the half-track got hit and was set on fire also. The crew was wounded and had yet again climb out of a new burning wreck. They all made it out safely, only what happened to the M3 half-track crew is unknown. I don't know what happened to the rest of the crew. Some sites say they died later on in World War II, and other sites say they died later on that day. I hope they made it out alive and had a happy life after the war.